recognition.
Mr. Speaker, I move to suspend the rules and pass H.R. 1098 as amended.
Clerk will report the title of the bill.
H.R. 1098, a bill to amend the Public Health Service Act to reauthorize certain programs relating to traumatic brain injury and to trauma research.
Pursuant to the rule, the gentleman from Pennsylvania, Mr. Pitts, and the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Green, each will control 20 minutes. Chair recognizes the gentleman from Pennsylvania.
Mr. Speaker, I ask unanimous consent that all members may have 5 legislative days in which to revise and extend their remarks and insert extraneous materials into the record on the bill.
Without objection.
Mr. Speaker, I yield myself such time as I may consume.
The gentleman's recognized.
Mr. Speaker, I rise today in support of H.R. 1098, the Traumatic Brain Injury Reauthorization Act, introduced by Representative Bill Pascrell of New Jersey, which will continue to provide the needed services that help patients with a traumatic brain injury, TBI. More than 3.17 million Americans live with a disability that resulted from a TBI, including children and adults, athletes and soldiers. The prevention and surveillance work done at the Centers for Disease Control keeps the public and providers aware of TBI research that leads to early diagnosis and treatment. Research at the National Institutes of Health improves the understanding of TBI and identifies treatments that will improve lives. Programs available at the Health Resources and Services Administration help families to better care for their members who suffer from a TBI. I urge my colleagues to support this important legislation and reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman from Pennsylvania reserves. Gentleman from Texas.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I yield myself as much time as I may consume.
The gentleman's recognized.
Mr. Speaker, I rise in support of H.R. 1098, the Traumatic Brain Injury Reauthorization Act of 2014. Traumatic brain injury, or TBI, is an unexpected blow or jolt to the head. These injuries affect people of all ages, a soldier in a blast injury, an elderly person who's fallen, or a young driver involved in a car crash can experience TBI. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention estimate more than 2 million Americans experience a traumatic brain injury each year. The vast majority of these individuals have an injury that can be treated at a hospital emergency room, but not all Americans are as fortunate. Their injuries can have more devastating consequences, may result in death or lasting disability. The TBI program at the Department of Health and Human Services was first established in 1996 and has been reauthorized twice, in 2001, again in 2008. The legislation before the House today once again reauthorizes the TBI program. It would extend TBI surveillance and research activities. It will also extend programs for TBI services support administered across Health and Human Services. I want to commend the sponsors of the legislation, Congressman Pascrell and Congressman Rooney, and I also want to acknowledge the leadership of Chairman Upton, Chairman Pitts, Ranking Member Waxman, Ranking Member Pallone, and the work of our committee staff in advancing this bill through the Energy and Commerce Committee and bringing it to floor today. I support this bipartisan bill and urge my colleagues to do the same, and I reserve my time.
Gentleman from Texas reserves. Gentleman from Pennsylvania.
Mr. Speaker, I reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman from Pennsylvania reserves. Gentleman from Texas.
Mr. Speaker, I yield to my good friend and colleague from New Jersey, Congressman Pascrell, as much time as he consumed.
Gentleman from New Jersey is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise today in support of the passage of this legislation, Traumatic Brain Injury Reauthorization Act of 2014. I want to thank Chairman Upton and Ranking Member Waxman, Chairman Pitts, my friend Ranking Member Pallone, Mr. Green, for their thoughtful consideration and support for millions of traumatic brain injury survivors and their families. Additionally, I want to thank my fellow co-chair of the Congressional Brain Injury Task Force, Congressman Tom Rooney of Florida, for his leadership on this important issue as well. Throughout my 13 years working on this issue, I've witnessed firsthand how these programs make a difference in people's lives. You've heard the numbers, but let's go beyond the numbers. Traumatic brain injury has become the signature wound of the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. 20% of our soldiers deployed are estimated to have experienced a brain injury. Many returning service members suffering from TBI will receive care and rehabilitation services within the Department of Defense and Veterans Affairs. But others suffering from TBIs that are initially undiagnosed or misdiagnosed will later look to the civilian community and local resources for information and services. That is why it is essential that we continue to foster civilian-military collaboration like the Department of Defense Center of Excellence for Psychological Health and Traumatic Brain Injury to build a system that ensures returning troops receive what they need to put their lives back together again. Unfortunately, TBI remains the silent epidemic in this country. That is why the legislation today is so critical. The TBI Act is the only legislation that specifically allocates federal funds for programs supporting individuals with brain injury. Originally, it was passed in 96 and reauthorized in 2000 and 2008. The TBI Act represents a foundation for coordinated and balanced public policy in the prevention, the education, the research, and community living for people living with TBI and their circles of support. And it has produced results. For nearly 18 years, the Traumatic Brain Injury Act has successfully provided direction and legal authority for the vast traumatic brain injury community. Grants within the TBI Act have helped states to improve access to health and other services for persons with TBI. And prior to this law, they did not have the tools to even access their own needs. Thanks to the TBI Act and its directive to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, we now have a record of incidents, including details and prevalence, plans for prevention, and finally, access to treatment. We've also begun to educate the public and provide much-needed scientific data for scientists, healthcare providers, and policymakers. Additionally, under this act, the National Institutes of Health is conducting basic and applied research in TBI, making great strides in our knowledge of the brain and the impact on the TBI. And, Mr. Speaker, this is in direct correlation to the President's initiative on the brain. We keep on meeting together to explore this new horizon for us, which I think is going to dramatically have very positive consequences. The Reauthorization Act of 2014 will elevate the TBI program within Health and Human Services by moving the program from maternal and child health children's program in acknowledgement of the impact of TBI across the age span, including older adults and returning service members and veterans. Our intention is for the program to be relocated to the Administration on Community Living to better coordinate with federal agencies regarding long-term services and supports available to individuals with other disabilities. Brain injury survivors from all walks of life and their families look to community and local resources for all types of information and assistance. Regardless of the source of the injury, this legislation will ensure the framework, the information and research resources are available to help. Mr. Speaker, only a strong commitment will allow us to continue the incredible advances we have made in the area of basic brain research, prevention, detection, early treatment, physical and mental rehabilitation, long-term care, and patient advocacy issues. I urge my colleagues to join me in support of this important bill, and I yield back, and I thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Gentleman yields back. Gentleman from Texas.
Reserve.
I'm prepared to close. I reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman from Texas is recognized.
I'll close it. I urge support for this legislation. I yield back my time.
Gentleman yields back. Gentleman from Pennsylvania.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This is another piece of important legislation, and it enjoys bipartisan support, and I urge the members to support it and yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman from Pennsylvania yields back. Question is, will the House suspend the rules and pass the bill, H.R. 1098, as amended? Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. In the opinion of the Chair, two-thirds being in the affirmative, the rules are suspended, the bill is passed, and without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid on the table.